And thank you.
So how far does your car go on a gallon of gas? 20 miles? 35 miles?
Well, even electric cars need to get charged at some point. But as we join Brian Hickey live this morning, some students out of Granite Bay High School are trying to reinvent fuel economy.
And let's just rewind. These high school students are building a car, period, let alone a car that's going to do some pretty cool things out here. We've got some of the students here with the Granite Bay program, and Amanda Gordon, one of them here. So what you got? This isn't just that you're building a car. You are building a car for competition.
We are. We're building this for the Shell Eco Marathon Americas. It's an international competition for college and high school students to build an alternative fuel vehicle.
All right, well, let's walk over there and show us the vehicle. Matt, come with us here and tell us a little bit about this. So this is the engine that's going to go in it. Tell us a little bit about it, Matt.
Well, this engine, it came out of a Honda scooter. We've converted it to be fuel injected, and it runs on ethanol, which is a biofuel, and it's an alternative fuel, and our goal is to make that engine be as efficient as possible.
And what do you think you're going to get out of it? How many miles per gallon do you think?
We're hoping to get 100-plus miles per gallon out of this engine.
And Amanda, I know you're busy working on the body, which is on the other side of the room. You're making that out of carbon fiber. In fact, let's show some of your drawings here. Tell us about the design.
The design was actually led by Matt over there, and it is going to be, we're calling it the Green Grizzly Machine. It is flat because most of the teams have curved carbon fiber, but we don't have the resources to do that. It takes specialized molds, so we're doing flat panels, like the ones over here, and we're molding them together. This is the gel coat on the side, so it's green. And then on this side, you have carbon fiber, and it's two layers here, and then you use a strip of carbon fiber to mold it together.
Are you driving this thing?
I'm the backup driver, so yes.
The backup driver. All right. Richard, come on over here. This is Amanda's dad, who's also the mentor for the program. And when you look at what these students have done, I mean, this is pretty impressive.
It's amazing that Granite Bay isn't set up to be a metal shop. They don't have all the equipment. And so I've got three other mentors that work with me. And they've taught them chassis design. They've taught them how to bend steel, how to do the carbon fiber, how to weld. All that's being done by the students, and they're learning how to do those processes.
And as far as you guys can tell, the only high school in California to enter the program, and let's tell everyone that they're pretty much going up against colleges. I mean, there's not a lot of high schools doing this.
That's correct. They're going against the big boys, Cal Poly. We have a relationship with Cal Poly. They've been helping us out, not in the construction, but in what to expect when we get to Huston.
All right. Well, we certainly wish you guys the best of luck. Great job to the team here at Granite Bay. The what'd you call it? The Green Grizzly Machine?
Green Grizzly Machine.
All right. Go Green Grizzly Machine here. And I don't know, maybe we can get this thing out at the All-American Speedway one day, too, and we'll speed check it. Back to you guys.
I'm sure you'd love to take a ride.
Awesome. Brian never strays far from his element, does he?
Exactly.
No, he doesn't. Loves the cars. All right. Thank you so much, Brian.